Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your boy Max here. Welcome everybody to vlog number 4. I'm seeing the Boston Bruins play a hockey game live today. But look at this behind me. This is the view behind me. Hold on, let me get out of cinematic. This is the view behind me down the street. Those are the mountains. There's more mountains over there that I could see from my Airbnb. But like, that is incredible. Like, I will never, ever get over this. And I said it so many times the last time I was here. But I will never get over the fact of seeing mountains. It's just the coolest thing. I sent a picture to my sister. Shout out to my sister. And she's like, yeah, our only mountains back here, because she's still in Saskatchewan. And she's like, our only mountains here are the snow mountains from shoveling all the snow, which is funny, but true. But you're wondering, no backpack on. It's +7 outside, which is, it's gorgeous outside. Again, it's sunny aside from those couple clouds over there. It's sunny. Really, really nice out. So I'm just wearing the sweater and I'm not wearing the backpack because I'm going to the Bruins game later. I'm not going to the Bruins game right now because I would have had my Marchand jersey on. But I'm just going to go get some food probably. Wanted to go for a bit of a walk. And I can't bring the backpack into Rogers Arena. They said that they don't accept backpacks in there. And then they said, put it in your car. I'm like, I don't have one of those. So it's not very great advice. We're gonna run some McDonald's. I'm gonna get a cheeseburger. So I know I said yesterday I was kind of craving a cheeseburger, so we're gonna get a cheeseburger now. I'm not wearing a long sleeve. Usually I wear a long sleeve, a t-shirt, and a sweater, but I'm not wearing a long sleeve today. I'm kind of regretting that. It's a little cold, a little chilly, a little nippy. McDouble, got a fry, got a medium double. Yeah. I'm not super hungry, so I'm not gonna get a bigger burger. But this is good. It'll tie me over for a bit. Ah! All done at McDonald's. These clouds, if y'all remember, they've gotten a lot closer. Just to say that. It also look a lot darker too. But also, let me know what y'all think about this hat. I think it looks banger. Regardless though, I'm gonna go back to the Airbnb. I'm gonna put on a long sleeve, because I know I'm probably gonna regret not wearing one. I am gonna be wearing my jersey over top of the sweater, so I'm probably gonna be hot later on. But it sucks, because usually I'd say, oh, I could just take my shirt off and put it in my backpack, but I can't bring my backpack to the game, so that's gonna suck. But regardless, it also isn't an arena, so I know it's obviously gonna be a bit colder. This is the only intersection, by the way, where like the crosswalk lights won't turn on unless I actually press the button. All the other ones, like, they'll automatically come on with the lights. This one I actually have to dig it in advance, so I can't cross the goddamn street. I just spilled like half my coffee on myself too, which is funny. Can I cross the street yet, please? I can cross the street. Absolutely beautiful. Yeah. I probably shouldn't be vlogging like such long clips right now because I've gotta still like vlog the game, and I'm crossing my fingers, man. I'm really crossing my fingers. I get noticed by a Bruin, and I get it on film, and I get a recording of it, because that would be so cool. But we'll see. Last time I went to a game in Edmonton, Zdeno Chara gave me a warm up puck, so that was pretty sick. The thing is that if a player sees that you're like older, they're less likely to give you a puck, especially if there's like a little kid beside you, which is rightfully so, you know, the little kid, give them experiences, but they're not even gonna remember that shit. They're not even gonna remember that. So just give it to me. All right, let's do this, boys and girls. Got the Bruins jersey on. We rock in the Marchand, obviously. And yeah, I'll head down towards the area of the arena. It's like 3 o'clock now. The game doesn't start till 7. So warm-ups won't be that far ahead of that. But yeah, it should be pretty fun. And obviously it will be fun. But yeah, fuck. I miss wearing my jersey. I don't wear my jerseys enough. I used to wear them all the time. Well, mainly when I'd go to school. If there would be a big Bruins game or something, I would go and... What am I trying to say? I'm losing my train of thought. I would wear my jersey on big games, especially playoff games and stuff like that. So it'd be fun. I feel so bare without my backpack, but it's also a good thing too, so people can actually see it's a Marchand jersey that I'm wearing. So I guess it works. I guess it makes sense. But I got like mask and all that stuff, and like my portable charger, and my charging cable. So it's all in my pocket, so it'll be good. And I won't have to worry about lugging that thing around. So I literally did it again. This time I don't have gloves, and I'm still getting a cold drink. So regardless, I'm just gonna walk around for a little bit. Doors open at 5. I got an email. Doors open at 5. The game starts at 6. It's 7 for back home. But yeah, so doors open at 5. So I should be... I'm gonna go in for 5. It's like 3:30 right now. So I've got a little bit of time. I'm not even at the arena yet anyway. So yeah, my hands are freezing. Or my one hand is freezing from carrying the ice cap. But first world problems, I guess. Just up there. I don't know if you saw that in the video. I think I have to cross here, which I will. Oh, police sirens. Oh boy. Coming out to arrest me already for being a Bruins fan. At the arena, we are here at Rogers. You can see the Canucks on the billboard, and we got like the Finnmobile and stuff like that down there, which is pretty cool. Right now, I am just hanging out. Again, the doors don't open. I actually just met two women, both Canucks fans. They were making fun of my Marchand jersey. And turns out they're from Saskatoon. One of them went to the same high school I did, which is like insane. Really small world. Really cool people too, by the way. And I saw a couple Bruins fans, which is encouraging because I'm not the only one here. So I feel a little safer. Absolutely beautiful. The sun starting to set and I'm getting pretty hyped. My hands are cold, but aside from that, we're chilling. Literally, we're chilling. People told me to go into this bar. I'm not really wanting to, being honest. Now there's multiple gates. It says I'm gate 7, but I also had somebody tell me that it doesn't really matter. So I'm not sure if I should go to gate 7 or not. We'll see how it goes. They're literally camping outside of the gate. I'm at gate 7 right here. Obviously they aren't opening the gates yet because they don't open until 5. We've got less than an hour. If you remember last time, there was the big ball, side swirl. This is pretty cool. I don't know if you can tell, my hands are red. I didn't want to bring gloves. I didn't want to have to carry, and I've never worn them while I'm here. Just complain a lot to my vlogs. In the arena. Let's go. My section is right behind me. I just passed it, but I'm going to walk around the arena a bit. Check it out. And yeah, let's go. And I got free Wi-Fi here. W. This is together. Look at that. Gorgeous. Gonna go over to my actual seat. I'm not hungry or anything right now, so I don't think I'm gonna go everyone walking in my direction. Swear to God. And then we'll go see what my robe's like. Insane, bro. That is so, oh fuck, this is massive. Bro, it's like, I'm so hyped. Okay, I'm row 11. Bro, these are my seats. These are my seats. Incredible, bro. Like, this is, look at this, man. I've been waiting for this for legitimately ever. This is fantastic. Prince Banner's up there. Retired number's up there. You can see the Sedin twins over there. As much as I am a Bruins fan, I love this arena. This is such a gorgeous, gorgeous arena. Wow. Like right over there by the glass, we'll see if I... There's already like a bunch of people waiting for how beautiful this arena is. I still think Rogers Place in Edmonton is slightly better just because it's way newer, but... Compared to SaskTel and Saskatoon, this goes hard. Thank you.
Scotland penalty, 442. Miller.
Tie game, baby. Overtime. Safe. Come on, Swayman. Oh. 2-1 loss in a shootout. I mean, like one of the most frustrating games I've watched. More thoughts on the game. Burns just did nothing this whole game. Like, Taylor Hall was invisible. The second line was pretty much invisible. Taylor Hall was demoted to Trent Frederick and Nick Foligno. Like, and it's his own fault. He did nothing, bro. He literally did nothing. Swayman is the reason why this game went to a shootout. Bruins get McDavid and Draisaitl tomorrow, which should be fun because the Canucks haven't been fantastic offensively, and there were a lot of missed nets by the Canucks. When Howla got his disallowed goal, it was like 8 2-on-1s consecutively by Vancouver, and Swayman stopped them, or it was a complete missed net by the Canucks. If that's Toronto, Tampa, Edmonton, those go in. So, it's unfortunate, but it is what it is. I had fun. Just would have been nice to pick up a win. I am now 0-2. Well, 0-0-2. Both Bruins games I've been to have been a shootout loss, so maybe I just won't go to games anymore. Regardless, though, I'll pick it up at some point. I'm gonna go over to Shark Club. It's only like 9:30. There's like some police presence just to like guide people, so there's not like traffic jams. As I was recording my Bruins game recap, some drunk guy came up to me and was like, "Are you recording a TikTok?" And then he was like, "I'd like to thank God." It was amazing. It was really funny. But yeah, I'm gonna go to Shark Club. I think I'm on the right way. I don't know. We'll see. Also, shout out to like the 5-6 people that I met today. Really appreciate you guys. You guys are our goats. If you ever see me out in public, come say hi. I'm pretty chill. Take a picture with me. But yeah, I'll pick it up when I'm at the Shark Club. While crossing that intersection, there was some dude with the cop cars that were there. There's some dude that came up. Arrest that Bruins fan. He was chill. These Canucks fans, like, they like to joke around. Also could be the fact that the Canucks won. Fucking honking at me. I'm trying to do a vlog, right? Racism. It's racist against Bruins fans. But yeah, I'm not drunk enough, so. Stop walking and going on my phone. I get lost, and like I turned what should be a 4-minute walk into now a 12-minute walk because I walked the wrong way this whole time. God damn it. All right, we're finished at the bar. Amazing. I love this place. The first guy that was sitting next to me dropped his mask on the floor, and he was like trying to get me to pick it up, and I was like playfully chirping. I'm like, no, I'm not gonna pick it up, and I was playfully having fun. Well, his friend was obviously embarrassed about that. He was trying to get him to stop, And I thought it was all in good fun. Like, I wasn't, like, upset by it at all. And then the guy's friend was like, he paid for my beer. He paid for one of my beers, which was so cool. And then there was another guy further, further down the bar that threw, like, a little paper ball at me, and it landed in, like, my my thing of shark bites, which is, like, pork bites. And he threw it at me, and then I'm like, nice shot, bro. And he's trying to piss me off. And then he's like, that was my second shot. I'm like, why would you say that's your second shot? You never say it's your second shot. You always say it was your first shot. And he's like, you know what? You're right. It was my first shot. And he thought it was cool, and he bought my other beer. So I got two free beers today. I'm literally jaywalked right now. Don't know why I just did that. I'm going to die. But yeah, like, really, really cool people. Like, obviously, I think they're playfully drunk to the point where, like, it's because the Canucks won, I think, is a huge part of it. But, like, if the Bruins had won, maybe it'd be a little bit of a different story. But at the same time, I think it was, like, it's just fun. Like, by me showing attitude or showing that I'm not having fun kind of gets them pissed off, sort of, because they're just trying to have fun. So I figured, let's just have fun. So I'm on the way back. I'm still kind of hungry. I'm not drunk this time, by the way. I only had three beers. I'll let y'all know what we do next. It's like midnight somehow. I don't know. Going to that Chevron again. Yesterday when I went to the Chevron, I couldn't open the door. So I don't know what the fuck was up with that. It's later out. Like, it's a later time than it was yesterday when I went, I think. So hopefully I can actually go get a drink. Like, the lights are on and everything. And it says it's open 24/7. Maybe he was just locked the door for me. I don't fucking know. We'll see.
It says 24 hours, but I can't open the door.
Just in there staring at you. Like, I know it's midnight, but, like, you can't open the door? I don't get the point of that. Why say 24 hours you're open till, if it's not 24 hours you're open till? It can pump gas for 24 hours, but what if someone needed to pay inside of the store for their gas? Like, there's somebody in there. I just wanted to get some peace tea and some chips or something. People, man, gotta do everything yourself. I mean, I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it. Get into my Airbnb. I'm gonna end the vlog outside of it, so I don't have to be super loud in the Airbnb. They didn't tell me to be quiet or anything. I just feel bad. So if you guys did enjoy this vlog, hopefully it was entertaining. I know I didn't vlog a whole lot at the game, but I want to enjoy the game, you know what I mean? And there's people beside me I don't want to vlog, and it's loud. So I hope the vlog was good enough for you guys. If you did enjoy it, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Peace out.